We have a keen... honestly, here is a... I'll give you a second to wake up the kids. We have quite an interesting combination on the show tonight. We have two gentlemen, both of whom... well, maybe you don't know so much about one. A comedian who is... you're not going to see anything like this gentleman anywhere in the world. Pee-wee Herman is here tonight. And if you don't know much about him, you're going to. And also a gentleman who you probably know a little bit more about. And I think this is the first time he has appeared with Pee-wee Herman. The Commissioner of Baseball, Bowie Kuhn, is here tonight. Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. And a fine program it is tonight. We have the Commissioner of Baseball, Bowie Kuhn, will be joining us later. And also, a rare behind-the-scenes glimpse, a profile of our audio man, Howard Vinitsky, sound effects man, Howard Vinitsky. So that'll be coming up soon. My first guest tonight is the host of his own children's program, and he also has a large and enthusiastic adult following. Please hang on to something. Welcome, Pee-wee Herman. You look great. You look terrific.
Thanks.
you brought. You're not nervous, are you?
Not a bit.
No. You have your own show, and
so do you.
Yeah, that's right. Now, you brought some toys along. I know you have a lot of props that you use for the kids' show.
You know what, Mr. Letterman? I wanted to just tell a story first, if I could, happened to me yesterday. This is a surprise on him. He doesn't know I'm going to do this, but... Okay, well, I came yesterday. I came a day early. As most of you probably don't know, I come from Los Angeles, is where I make my home. And so the summer just ended there, and I run a lemonade stand out in front of my house there. And that's how I kind of, make my money when I'm not doing big stuff like this. So I came out here a day early, and I came in, and I was hanging out here in the writer's room yesterday. And we met a couple of years ago, remember, when we met? And so he came in, this guy, Mr. Letterman, came in yesterday, and I was sitting there, and he goes, "Hi, Pee-wee, how you doing?" I said, "Fine, Mr. Letterman, how are you?" And he goes, "Good." And then he goes, "While you're in New York, why don't you do the show?" I couldn't believe it, because that's what I was here for. I mean, what else would I have even been doing here? He cracked me up yesterday. I didn't even get to tell you, so I thought I'd,
That's darn nice of you. You like New York City?
Yeah, I love it. Yeah. Crazy about it.
It's exciting, isn't it?
I'm going to try Quebec and be one of those Green Beret guys here.
No, those are the Guardian Angels. It's actually a Red Beret.
Red Beret.
Yeah, yeah. Those are tough gentlemen. You don't want to wise off to those fellas.
No.
No. Now, you have some toys, huh?
Yeah.
You want to show us?
Yeah, I have a whole bunch of toys. I have this pirate sword right here. No, laugh or you get it. Okay, I have this boomerang right here. Watch this. This I just got right here. Look at this.
That's nice.
Okay. I have this right. This right here is a real cool toy. I used to use this on my show, and it's a little guy. And he goes like a. Okay, wait. That's not all. Though. Look. Okay, you see this one right here. Okay, well, look right here. Look. Here's this little baby. Look. Look. Now both at once.
We have some film, I understand, you brought with us, Pee-wee.
Yeah. Who told you all this?
Well,
stuff?
It's right here in the notes. See, I understand you got a film about lunchroom manners.
And I'm going to be able to get right inside the film.
You're actually going to appear in the film.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, what do we need to do in by way of setting this
up? Well, all I need to do is just get up and go be in it.
All right. Are we all set for Pee-wee to get up and go be in it? All right, Pee-wee.
Okay.
Pee-wee Herman, ladies and gentlemen.
When Phil got there, he saw some boys he knew at the front of the line.
I fell.
They waved for him to go up to the front with them. But Phil didn't want to break into line, as Mr. Bungle did. So Phil went to the end. That was the fair thing to do. He put his knife, fork, and spoon neatly on the tray. And then he slid his tray along.
My tray.
He always enjoyed looking at the good food in the cafeteria. It tasted good, and was good for him, too.
A hamburger.
Instead of having a sandwich today, Phil decided to take the hot lunch. Phil took some bread and butter, too. And he knew what else he wanted.
Some
milk. Alice took the last carton on the tray. Maybe there was more milk. So he said, "May I please have some milk?" Phil remembered to say, "May I?" and "please." That was very polite. Yes, there was more milk.
Night of the Living Dead!
Phil remembered to say, "Thank you," when he took the carton of milk. Phil had good manners. He didn't want to be like Mr. Bungle in the lunchroom. Phil didn't want to forget his dessert. The cake looked delicious. At the end of the line, the lunchroom supervisor said she had noticed how polite Phil was, and she smiled at him. She wouldn't smile at a Mr. Bungle. Phil went to the table where his friends were.
Very nice film. Very nice. You know, the thing that I liked about that, it was entertaining as well as informational.
Well, thanks. Yeah. It was a lot of fun for me to do, too.
Yeah, yeah. and you have some more toys that we're going to take a look at now, Pee-wee?
Yeah, I have a whole bunch of toys right here. I have this right here.
Hand grenade! Ah!
Okay, I have...
Oh, that's nice. Yeah.
David Letterman, please pick up the white courtesy telephone.
Want to try it or anything?
No, that's all right. We have to pause now. We'll get Pee-wee some Darvon. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen, with Pee-wee Herman. Welcome back to the show. Pee-wee Herman is here, and later the commissioner of baseball, Bowie Kuhn, will be joining us. Now, we didn't plan any of this, but you dance. I remember you as being a very good dancer. Is there any way, without throwing everybody here, that you could show us a little of that?
Well, pull my leg a little. Can I? Oh, sure, I can do it. I think this is what you're referring to. It requires a lot of concentration, so if you just be quiet for just a minute.
Thank you. Thank you very much. You are a...
I have another one, too, I've been working on. This is my devil dance. It sort of goes like this. That's a new one. It's kind of a combination of the donkey and the devil. I think I'm going to call it the devil donkey dance, but I'm not sure.
Now, in addition to showing us all these wonderful toys, you have some thoughts on as to how you can have fun without toys.
Yes, I do. I'm glad you asked me that. I have some stuff that you can kind of do right around the house if you don't have toys of your own, like this. You can play disguise, you know. You could just, you know, do stuff like this. Mm-hmm. Where's Pee-wee? you know. Okay, don't laugh. Okay. And then there's this. If your mom or dad's fat, okay, shut up. Okay. If you have some big underpants lying around the house, you know, you'd be surprised how much you could do with this. I mean, you could fill up a whole hour just playing with big underpants. You know, like look, you could do kind of. So you can do this kind of thing, where you can make, you know, you can make kind of a vest or an arrow kind of look like this, or you can like pull them all the way down like this, and like, you know, you can make a, You can make a turban out of it. There's so many uses for them, you know, besides wearing them.
Yeah. And I can see where the hour would just fly by with those.
And also, this is something that I figured everybody could do. This, I kind of like to think up stuff to make people go about, you know, go crazy, you know, kind of obnoxious kind of stuff to do around the house. Like if you have a younger brother or a younger sister, you want to make them go crazy. So I have this can, you know, it's just a nut can. Any kind of can will do it. It's just got some nuts inside of it. You put the top back on it like this. Okay, now this is to make somebody go crazy, okay? So, and it works every time. What you do is you see how it makes this noise right here like this? Okay, well, suppose that I wanted to make you go crazy, okay? You're the one since you're right here. Okay, so we'll use your name just because you're here, okay? So David Letterman's his name, so that's what we'll use. You'd substitute your brother or sister or mom or dad for this, okay? So you go like this.
You're going to sing, in addition to all of these other things, you're going to sing for us tonight.
You know why I'm going to sing?
No, why is that?
Because I've always wanted to be on a show like this and just be calmly sitting here and have you or someone else go, you know, I know you have a song for us.
Okay, you know, I know you have a song prepared for us.
I sure do.
So, Pee-wee, if you want to go on over there, I'll introduce it for
you,
for everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, Pee-wee Herman.
In 1814, we took a little trip down the Mississippi, down the mighty Mississippi. We took a little bacon and we took a little pizza. We fought the bloody British at the town of New Orleans. Well, we fired our guns and they began running. There wasn't as many as there was a while ago. We fired once more and they began running.
Very nice. We have to pause for a commercial. We'll be right back. Pee-wee Herman, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, now.
All you have to do is just put it on your head. Just put your head out, like, you know, kind of like that, and just stick your head in it. Then you
is moist in here. why would this be moist?
I don't know.
I don't know either. I don't think I want to be in there. No.
Look, I brought this is a toy shaver. Look.
Yeah.
It doesn't really do anything, though, you know. I'm shaving just like daddy. La, la, la.
Now, I know that in addition to your kid show that there is talk now, or I guess there is going to be a Pee-wee Herman movie.
Well, there might be a Pee-wee Herman movie. We just spent, me and the guy who designed the set for the Pee-wee movie, we wrote this script. It took us about 7 months, and we sat in this room, and we went, okay, what do you do now? What's the next thing? Okay, what happens next? And we wrote it every day, and it came out really great. It's an epic adventure story. It's called Pee-wee's Big Adventure. It's sort of like the Wizard of Oz kind of thing. And it's really swell. We turned it into the movie studio Paramount Pictures, and we turned it in, and they went, well, what have you been doing for 7 months? You haven't been doing anything but writing. Nobody knows who you are. You haven't been out there doing anything or anything. So I go, well, yeah, I was writing a script. What am I supposed to be doing? And they go, well, I don't know what you're supposed to be doing, but nobody's heard of you or anything. So I go, well, what if I go on David Letterman? And they go, well, that would be helpful, you know, because... So the thing is, now I have this whole film script written for Pee-wee's Big Adventure, and it's a really swell film, and it'll probably be better than E.T. even. And I don't even know if they're going to make it now, because now they go, well, you're really a nobody, and nobody really knows who you are or anything, so, you know, so if you know who I am, then I don't know what.
Yeah, that's too bad. That's too bad. You went to the meeting with the executives yourself?
Yeah, I sat in there and pitched it, you know, as you say.
Yeah. How about your folks? Are your parents proud of you, Pee-wee?
Yeah, they're real proud of me. They don't tell a whole bunch of people that they're my parents, but they're proud of me.
Can we ask you what else is in the box? Do you have anything else there you want to share with us?
Well, I have my little pet skunk right here. He just goes like that, you know. You know, that kind of thing. And, yeah. You know, sniff at you, snoo, you know, that kind of stuff. But you know, he doesn't stink or anything because he's just a puppet.
That's right. He should, yeah. Yeah. Okay.
So, I have this bug right here, this beetle. Look, is... Get it, beetle?
Yeah, there it goes. Well, it's been a delight having you here, and whenever you're back in New York City, I want to invite you to drop in and keep us posted on how things are going for Pee-wee
okay,
Herman.
I think I'm
going
to be back here next week, so... Oh. I'm just kidding.
Okay, well, good. We'll look forward to seeing
Thanks
you again.
A lot.
And good
it's
luck with that
time.
Film. Okay. Pee-wee Herman, ladies and gentlemen. Quite a man, isn't he? 'Thank you very much, and welcome back to the program. We have a fine show for you tonight. Devo is here, also a tour of Central Park, and my first guest, who has been here before, he is the host of a popular children's program, the Pee-wee Herman Show, which elicits giggling everywhere in North America. We're delighted to have him back with us tonight for his second appearance on Late Night. Welcome, please, Pee-wee Herman. Nice to see you again.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for having me back on.
Yes, sir. First of all, here is your there's your cranberry sauce.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah. You have a... did you get this in Hawaii?
Look, watch this. See, it has a little wristwatch thing.
And a little car drives up. That's exciting. Yeah, yeah. Do you want this back?
Sure, why not?
Yeah. Now.
Well, you gave me the cranberry sauce.
Oh, okay. That's very nice of you. I appreciate that.
You mind if I smoke?
No, go right ahead.
See, a giant lighter.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did get this in Hawaii.
You were in Hawaii.
Yeah,
were
Hawaii.
You Hawaii, fine.
Yeah, I was in Hawaii.
Just on vacation, were you?
Well, not really. See, all the surfers in Hawaii invited me to come to Hawaii because they thought I was really cool and everything. So they called me up and they said, "Hey, Pee-wee, why don't you come to Hawaii and learn how to surf and underwater dive and all that kind of stuff?" So I did.
Mm-hmm. It was a lot of fun, was it?
Yeah, was it? It was really fun. I was pretty scared to go underwater and everything. You know, that was pretty scary because I'd never been in water except in the bathtub, you know, and I'd never even been in a swimming pool or anything. So, you know, they made me go underwater, and I learned how to go underwater, and then I went all the way underwater, and then after that, I got out of the pool and I went in the ocean.
Oh, wow.
Thanks. Right on. Look, I got this little wallet. I don't know if you can see this or not right here. It's got a Hawaiian surfer on it.
Right.
And then look, inside, I got this in Hawaii. Right inside, look, Magnum PI identification.
Nice.
You know what, David? I brought something for you, too.
Your folks must be really proud of you, huh? That's just a joke. I'm just joking.
I'm an orphan.
No.
I'm just kidding. I'm really not. Look, I brought this from Hawaii for you. Look, it has your American name, David, and then right here is your Hawaii name, Kawika. How you doing, Kawika?
That's very nice, man. May I have this?
Yeah, you can sew it on your jacket.
I will. I'll be sure to do that.
Okay, I'll be sure to check and make sure you did.
Yeah, I will. I'll be proud to have this on here.
You know what? Look, I got this too since I'm in New York, you know, for protection. Look. Ah!
Yeah. Oh, what is that? Oh,
it's a little toy switchblade, a little tiny one.
Yeah. Now, we have this film. Are we going to take a look at the film now?
Yeah. We're going to look at it
this
in two
parts.
This
is from Hawaii.
This is from Hawaii. We're going to look at it in two parts. First, we're going to just see me in Hawaii, and then we're going to see me learning how to just be underwater in the swimming pool. Then, I'm going to play with some more toys for a little while. Then I'm going to come back. See, this way I knew I could stretch the whole thing out a little bit more. And show me actually skin diving with scuba tanks and everything under the water.
Yeah. So this could be almost too much entertainment, huh? Okay, now... give you some more cranberries, Pee-wee. There
Thanks,
you go. now, do we want to look at... We going to look at this now?
Is that, sure, I guess
okay,
so.
Fine. If you just watch the monitors,
yeah, narrate,
and you'll narrate
right
the film right over the... Okay, at home, use your TVs. That should help. Pee-wee Herman in Hawaii.
Okay, here we are. Here I am. This is the beautiful island of Hawaii. There's me right there! There I am!
La la la! Hello, everyone!
That's my name. See, it's really bright in Hawaii, so...
Yeah.
Like glasses.
You get... You have quite a tan.
Yeah, you know, I didn't get out in the sun too much.
Look, surf's up, look! La la la, la 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 la.
Oh!
This is unbelievable stuff.
There I am, learning how to breathe underwater with the nose clips on, smelling my finger. Combing my hair underwater. upside down. Look, I'll sniff the bubbles.
David Letterman.
See, there's me saying your name underwater. There's my dance.
Now, did you produce that with a grant from the National Geographic Society? Boy, was that exciting stuff.
Thanks. Well, you know, you just turned the camera on and took it underwater. It was pretty fun.
Yeah.
Hey, how about a nice Hawaiian punch right now?
No.
A nice Hawaiian punch right here. Here's some for you.
Oh, that, now some you got me. A little on my...
I'll
save mine
for later.
Send
me the bill.
Okay. <I will. laughs> I'll just put this over here.
I love this stuff. It's a Hawaiian punch from Hawaii. Get it?
Yeah, I do get it. I think what we're going to do here is we'll just...
just kidding.
I think what we'll do is pause here and strangle Pee-wee. And then we'll be right back. Thank you, sir. Hi there, and welcome back to the show. We have Pee-wee Herman with us, also Devo, coming up in the next half hour. Do you like Devo pretty well, Pee-wee?
Yeah, I like him really swell. I think they're really great.
Yeah.
Rip it!
Now.
Hey, David, I forgot to give you this. This is a little lay for you from Hawaii.
Oh, thank you very much. Do I have to put it on?
Well, you don't have to.
No, I guess I don't.
Hey, look at my shoes. These shoes right here, they're called reef walkers, and they're for walking on the reef. Look.
Yeah.
Can you see them okay?
Yeah, I think we... Yeah.
There they are.
Crab feet.
Okay.
Now, if people are wondering, we are going to have the second half of the Pee-wee Herman Hawaii film.
Yeah.
Do you want to do that now, or do you want to?
Well, I don't care. We can do that now, or I can show you some more stuff right here. Show some more stuff here first.
Show us a few things here first.
Okay. Look right here. Look,
I got the whole world in my hand.
That's great.
Get it. Look,
I got the little bitty baby.
That's great.
Okay. Look, maybe you can help me with this if you just hold this guy right like this, okay?
All right.
Okay, we're gonna make this little thing right here, okay?
Okay, this is G.I. Joe. Hello. Ah. Hey, how you doing?
Thanks for helping me out. These are macadamia nuts from Hawaii. This
from
is a
Hawaii,
can
yes,
of Hawaiian
right.
nuts. Remember this part?
Yeah, I do remember that. Do you have any sodium pentothal in there, Pee-wee?
I did have some.
Big steak!
Okay. Look.
Butter. Margarine. Margarine.
I get it. You want to go? You want to take a look at the rest of the Hawaiian film?
Sure, why not?
All right, we're sort of in a holiday mood here. The festivities of Pee-wee's Vacation unfolding before us.
Okay, this is back in Hawaii now. This is after I've been in the swimming pool and I've learned how to go underwater. Now I'm gonna go out and go underwater.
So that's what the folks at home will be seeing now.
That's right.
Might want to wake the kids. Here we go.
Okay. There I am out at Poi Pool Beach, ready to come on and lay you. There's me swimming out. And here I am. Look, I'm underwater. I'm King Neptune. Ow! 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 Look, I'm a pirate. Here's me with some fake steak like the one I just had right there, shark bait. trying to get the water pistol to work underwater.
Look, it's mountain grown coffee.
Look, the pause that refreshes. don't shake it underwater.
The glitter chopsticks. I'll eat a bug.
Look, a stingray. These things are very, very... You have to be very careful playing with stingrays underwater because they have really sharp teeth. See, look.
Yeah. Ow! Ow! My thumb! My thumb! Ow! Ow! Ow!
Uh-oh, look. What's this? Looks like dog doom. It smells like dog...
It is dog doom!
Look, you're giving me a heart attack. Heart attack, heart attack. Singing Olivia Newton-John's song, Heart Attack, underwater. And look, here's me practicing how to wear my big platform shoes underwater. There's my fake cigar in my hand, too. I'm gonna smoke a cigar and wear big shoes underwater.
La la la, big shoes.
Telephone.
Hey, your air's running out. It's time to come up. Come on, get out of the water.
I couldn't hear anything or talk underwater, though. And there's me swimming away, leaving the Hawaiian Ocean right there.
That was great. Do you write a lot of this stuff?
I made this all up myself.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, that's interesting.
Can you believe it?
No. Now, we're going to have to go away here, Pee-wee.
Okay.
Yeah, and then for station identification, and then you'll be here, is that right?
Yeah, I'll be
all
here.
All right. We'll pause and return after station identification. Let me tell you about, of course, Devo will be joining us, and on Monday, legendary film director Frank Capra will be here, also actress Carol Kane and comedian Jeff Altman, and tonight, of course, we have Mr. Pee-wee Herman, and we're certainly...
There's three things that I have to do really quick before I leave. I have to thank Nicholas Constantino, Nick Colliados, Mike Ornstein, and Clarita Berger for helping me with the movie. And I wanted to show this, if you could catch this. Are you familiar with that symbol, the Chinese symbol for yin yang? Look, I found a symbol. I found this symbol in yin yang, and look, it's two fish.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
Two little fish. Look, I gotta show you one thing else before I leave, and I'm not leaving until I do this. So look.
La 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 la. Look. La 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 la.
That's great.
See, look.
La 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 la. La. This is Wanda Walker. Look. Hello, Mr. Letterman.
Hi. Yeah. I bet you're good on a rainy day, aren't you?
Hey, speaking of the that. You know, here's something fun you can do on a rainy day if you're all by yourself and you don't have anything to do and it's raining and pouring out. You can pretend that your hand is a monster and it's trying to get you. Look. See that?
Yeah.
All it takes is one hand.
Yeah.
Hey, you want to hear the dirtiest joke in the world?
Sure.
Two white horses fell in the mud. Oh, really, really mature.
Gee, Pee-wee, I can't believe our time has finally come to an end.
Well, it was really, really fun.
It was a great deal of fun for me.
Anytime you want me to come back.
Okay, we'll have you back real soon.
Okay, you heard it.
Okay. We have to pause here. Pee-wee, oh no, thank you, Pee-wee. Okay, we have to do something here. Why don't you just...
Okay.
Oh, okay. Goodbye, Pee-wee. That's all right. We'll clean this stuff up, Pee-wee. Next guest, ladies and gentlemen, is the host of his own popular children's show, it says here, and always a welcome visitor, it also says here, at late night. Welcome, please, for a return engagement, Mr. Pee-wee Herman.
Before I came down and talked to Mr. Letterman, so why doesn't everybody just go,
hi, Pee-wee?
Hi, Pee-wee!
Okay, medium crummy, okay? All right, we are going to do this till everyone participates, so you might as well just do it right now, okay? Okay, save yourself a little time. One, two, three.
Hi, Pee-wee!
Hi, audience! okay, hey, anybody feel like a Tootsie Roll right now? Okay, right over there. Okay, think fast. Okay, fake out. Okay, over there. Okay. Okay, let's put his eye out with it.
Okay, okay, right up there.
Okay, they're going cuckoo for him. Okay, what is your name, ma'am?
Hi, I'm Marilyn.
Marilyn?
This is Emily.
Okay, what brings you to the show?
Ask her. I'm in love with David.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I love that story. Okay, what's your name?
Gerard.
Gerard, okay, for the duration of the show, your name's going to be Gerardo, okay? Okay, and what's your sister's name?
Noreen.
Noreen O. Okay, and what's your name?
Mary Jean.
Mary Jean O. Okay. Okay, and what's your name, sir?
Tom.
Tom O. Okay, right. Okay, right now, we're going to play a little game called Pee-wee Says, okay? It's really simple. It's just like, okay, shut up. Okay, it's just like Simon Says, only it's Pee-wee Says, okay? Okay? Okay. All right. Okay, everybody ready? Pee-wee Says, put your hands up in the air. Very good. Okay, Pee-wee Says, take them down. Very good. Pee-wee Says, laugh real loud. Pee-wee Says, shut up. Okay, raise your right hand. I didn't say Pee-wee Says. Duh. Okay, Pee-wee Says, standing ovation.
Nice.
Okay.
Nice to see you, Pee-wee.
Yeah, same here. Thanks.
How are things?
Pretty good.
Good. You seem to have settled down considerably since the last time I saw you. Now we have a little. We have a list here of things you've brought to show and demonstrate.
Before that, Mr. Letterman, I just wanted to kind of explain about my new pants and everything because you know a lot of people were watching me on your show before and telling me you know people you look kind of you know nerdy and stuff. So. So, I decided to go for kind of a more hipper, you know, mod kind of look. So I'm growing my hair longer, and I got these long pads and stuff. Would you mind mopping me down a little bit?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah,
no, that's all right. Why don't you just go ahead and maybe get a squeegee for you later.
That's so funny, I forgot to laugh.
Yeah. Now we have this list of stuff here. Which do you want to get to?
Lately, that I'm much more comfortable with my big shoes on right now. So I'm just gonna put these on.
All right, you slip into those shoes.
Well, we're talking. You know what? I even have a big shoe dance. Would you like to see that?
Oh. Yeah. Oh yeah, we'd like to see it.
Okay. I'm gonna go do it right over here.
Okay.
Okay. This is my big shoe dance. Okay. Ready?
One peculiar son of a bitch, Pee-wee. We'll be right back with Pee-wee Herman. Herman and I are here, and what do you want to do, Pee-wee?
Well, I just wanted to grab a real quick bite because I didn't get to eat very much before I came on the show.
Uh-huh.
And remember these kind of cereal boxes
yes,
where you
can pour
the milk right in like that?
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
Yeah, I was wondering maybe if you'd mind just feeding me a couple spoonfuls of it. Come on.
Just a little?
Yeah, come on.
Just one.
Okay, just give me a big spoonful, okay?
You're the first human I've fed.
I'm flattered.
You are flattered. All right.
Yeah, I'll just have a little music while we're eating, okay?
Okay, a little music.
Okay, that worked.
Okay.
Okay. Ready? Come on, you have to make it like an airplane and go, mmm. Come on.
Okay, why don't you go ahead and finish up? You're probably full now anyway, aren't you?
Yeah. Hey, I want to show you this cool toy that I got for Christmas, okay?
Look,
this is Casper the Friendly Ghost, okay? Watch this.
Will you play with me?
You're not listening.
Can you make a spooky sound?
What's my ghost? Okay, hey, look at this toy right here. Watch this. Hey, would you like to be blood brothers?
No, that's all right. Now,
look at my little chainsaw. Look. Dave, have you had a physical very, very recently?
Not recently,
physical?
No, I haven't.
Good,
how about you?
You said no, because, look right here. Okay, okay. For first, we have to test your head reflex right now. Okay. See, look, I can play a little piano. Oh, really mature? Shut up. Look, we can pull some blood out. Look.
How old are you exactly? How old are you?
I never give my age away because I never do.
Now,
would you like to take some dolls right now?
Take some
some pills, you know, Gog, no, belly of the dolls.
No, help yourself. Take all you need there. Maybe take some for later.
I'm saving some for later. I think maybe, well, the gloves are so small, we'll skip the, you know, the glove thing. And I'm just going to give you this, and if you could just fill this up after the show.
Okay, fine.
Show's over, okay?
Now,
get your mind out of the gutter. And we can just tell right here.
Oh.
Put him in your ears.
Hello, Pee-wee.
I understand the last time you visited with us, you received, after your appearance, kind of an interesting letter from...
Right here. Listen to this letter. I'm a viewer from Colorado who was watching your Thursday, 18th November show, which included Mr. Pee-wee Herman. As a medical specialist in endocrinology...
What is it? Endocrinology.
I could not help noticing that Mr. Herman appears to be suffering from a relatively rare genetic disease, 1 in 1 million, called... Or Marfan syndrome, since this disease is often missed in routine physical examinations and since it has potentially serious consequences when it goes unrecognized and untreated, I'm very much hoping you will kindly pass this note on to Mr. Herman.
Well, we did, and have you talked to a physician about
this? No, are you kidding?
Okay. We have to go away for a commercial, but the telethon will continue. Welcome back. We're nearly at the end of our epic journey here tonight. I want to, first of all, thank Mr. Bob Costas from NBC Sports for helping us cover the taxi race. A nice job as always, Bob. And let me thank the participants in the competition. Marilyn Keller, by the way, who finished third. Marianne Balowicz, who was our second place winner, and our champion, Vincent P. Salisi. Congratulations to everybody who helped us out here tonight. I'd also like to thank Shaka Khan for being here. Mr. Pee-wee Herman. Pee-wee, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Good luck with that painful series of injections I know you'll be undergoing shortly.
Thanks.
Also, my thanks to Madeline Kahn for being here. Hope to see her again soon. And Larry Bud Melman, always a joy to have Mr. Melman with us. Paul and the band. Paul, can we have Mr. Sanborn back occasionally, do you think?
It'd be
terrific. David Sanborn on alto saxophone. I'd like to thank Bill Wendell and our studio audience. Monday night, Jerzy Kosinski and Jeff Altman will be here. Have a good weekend. Thank you, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, my first guest tonight is the host of his own very successful children's television program, although it's hard to prove. He will also be appearing here in New York at Caroline's from June 7th through June the 11th. Please welcome back Pee-wee Herman.
Okay.
Dad forgot to laugh.
Okay. Hi, miss. What's your name?
Nancy.
Nancy, would you stand up right here for just a second? I'd like to just give you a kiss, okay?
Okay.
Thanks a lot. Okay, and what's your name, sir? I'm just kidding. Okay. Okay, I got a little thing that I'm gonna do right now. Real quick, so. Okay, I wanna just take a picture of everybody right now, because this way when I get home I have something, you know, Okay, so if everybody could just like kind of, you know, scrunch it together. Okay, and you, if you could just stitch yourself up a little bit back there, okay? Okay, now they got a movie camera right here. So this time everybody has to be kind of animated, okay? And wave and move around, okay?
Where the pistol?
Okay. Okay, now I need a volunteer from the audience, okay? Okay, you, sir, right there in the red. Come right down here. Come right down. Okay, just step right in here. Okay, what is your name, sir?
Howie.
Holly.
Howie!
Okay, Holly, would you just put these on right now?
Could you take a little longer?
Okay. What we're gonna do, Holly, is we're gonna reenact a scene from The Creature from the Black Lagoon. And this right here is the creature mask right here. And you're gonna play some funny. You're gonna play the creature right here. So just stick this out over your face. Okay, great. Now you just stand right here. Okay, now, shut up, okay? Okay.
I'll do the jokes, Howie. You just stay right there. Okay,
I'm Pee-wee Herman, and I'm out in the swamp.
La, 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 la. Sure is a beautiful day out in the swamp. I hope I don't see any monster.
For a commercial, Pee-wee, but we'll return and we'll have plenty of time
to talk. Okay.
So, we'll be right back. Thank you very much. Pee-wee Herman is here. Now, let me ask.
Hey, did you notice my wolf pants? Look, they have little wolves all over them. Look.
Those are great. Now, let me ask you about...
Look at my glass, look.
Having a soothing beverage, are you? Okay, now, it says you are the host of your very own successful children's program. Now, where would one go to see this program?
You can't see it.
Uh-huh.
It was on a couple of years ago on Home Box Office.
A couple of years ago?
Yeah, well... but you know, I'm gonna be on a lot of other stuff too. I just finished playing Pinocchio.
Oh, Pinocchio.
Yeah. It's gonna be on Showtime, and you know who produced it? You know who's the producer?
No.
Shelley Duvall. You know that girl that played Olive Oil?
I know who she is. Yeah.
She and my nose grew. I had 10 inches.
Uh-huh. Oh my.
Yeah, there's a picture of it right there. And that was my father, Carl Reiner, played Geppetto right there.
Oh, my nose!
Did you enjoy that?
Yeah, it was really, really fun.
Yeah. So how are things going?
Really, really swell.
Oh, good.
Look, I brought you one of my T-shirts. Look. Yeah, because you wear T-shirts all the time.
Yeah, that's right.
So I brought you that. And because I've been on this show so much.
This has been laundered, hasn't it, Pee-wee?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And look, Pee-wee Press. That's a newspaper. I have a club and everything. And look, here's a secret wallet card. And it looks like just a regular old business card. But then look. See, it's a secret thing. And I wrote your secret club name in there, Dave O. I cracked you up.
Now, why is it Dave O?
Dave O? Well, that's your secret name, because your real name's Dave, so Dave O, and then, you know, nobody will know it's you.
I can travel incognito with the aid of this.
Yeah, you know how. Look, here's how I travel incognito when I don't want anybody to know who I am. Look, Chaka Khan!
Yeah, these are fascinating little things you've brought us here tonight. Now, you have other things. We're going to go away for a commercial,
okay.
Station identification, and then we're coming back and you can do anything else you want. We'll be right back, folks. Welcome back to the show. Pee-wee Herman is here. Dr. Demento will be joining us. And tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, author Rita Mae Brown. I can't see that far. Who is it? Johnny Winter will be here tomorrow. And Kirk Newrock and his singing pigs. That'll be tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen. Pee-wee Herman is here tonight. I was just looking over this issue of the Pee-wee Press, Pee-wee. Fun fan stats. I didn't realize this. Of course, your full name is Pee-wee Herman, but it says right here that your nickname, which I am surprised to know, is Pee.
Look.
You have the silly-looking teeth in there.
These are my donkey teeth from Pinocchio. Look. Yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh. Now, also, did I see you in the hall smoking earlier, Pee-wee, before the
Not
show?
Not me, no.
It looked to me like you had a butt going.
Cross my heart and hope to die.
Really? I thought you had... Well, this is quite a nice little newspaper. You have your photo here with the Go-Go's.
Yeah.
And this looks like
Me and the
Steve
Go-Go's
Martin.
Are just like this.
Uh-huh. And Lou Ferrigno.
Lou Ferrigno, yeah. Incredible Hulk.
So that's a very nice thing to have.
Hey, Mr. Letterman, I was wondering if there was one thing that we could play right here for a second.
Sure.
It's an obnoxious game. Remember my David Letterman? Remember that?
Obnoxious, unlike the rest of it so far tonight, huh?
Wait, this is called the Echo Game.
So the Echo Game, sure.
Oh, the Echo Game, sure.
I'd love to play.
I'd love to play.
How does the game work?
How do you play?
anything I say. Yeah. And then
how long will the game go on? Yeah. That's all. Hey, look, here's another fun thing. Look, put your hands in the back of you like that. Okay, look.
Take me downtown. Oh.
Hello.
Remember playing that game?
Yeah, you mean just a second ago?
Yeah. Over here. So I gotta come down here for a second. Because this is called fun with caps, okay? Look. Okay. Okay, that's fun with caps. And now I got one more thing I gotta show you because I do a lot of stuff with shoes. Remember last time I was on, I had that big shoe dance and everything. So this time, watch my shoes right now because now I have another shoe dance for you with my sneakers. Okay, ready?
Let me just interrupt you here. You can do it all. You know it?
It's what you call multi-talented.
You can do everything.
This next segment is called Close Up with Pee-wee. And what we have to do is have to come over to the camera and come right in. Come right in. Closer. Closer.
Jeez.
Closer. 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 Look, look. Hello. 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 Look. Hello. 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 Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. Look.
Oh, my gosh, is that the phone?
I'll get it. look. Hello. Look, here's here. Look right here. It's my fake nipple.
Oh, jeez.
you know what? Look at this. Look.
What do you?
Corn Monica. Corn Monica. This right here is my little moron doll, Donnie, right here. look. I'm a little bit rock and roll. Hey, Mr. Letterman, you want to hear an impression of my next door neighbor?
Are your parents still alive?
Look, here's an impression of my next door neighbor. Uh-huh. His name is Moses, and they call him Mo. And he always looks like he's smelling something bad. Here's what his face looks like. Look. Here's how he talks. Look.
You're going on what show?
This is what he says. He goes,
you got another Letterman? Letterman, I thought they were out of the business.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Pee-wee Herman, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Pee-wee. We'll be right back to pay a visit to the 7th Annual Worldwide Inventors Expo. Welcome back to the program, folks. My first guest tonight has completed a very successful engagement at the Tyrone Guthrie Theater in Minneapolis and begins a run at Caroline's here in New York City. That's tonight. Welcome, please, Pee-wee Herman. Nice to see you.
Thanks. How's it going?
Going pretty well.
Hey, Mr. Letterman, first of all, I wanted to bring you this. It's a 4th of July gift, and it's for you, and it was made by my sister expressly for you.
That's very nice. Your sister, is she older or younger?
She's younger.
Younger, and what is her name?
Her name is Hermione Herman. Everybody in my family's name begins with H. My grandfather's Herman Herman. My dad's Herman Herman. My brother's Herman Jr. My mom's name's Honey Herman, you know.
Uh-huh. And what about you? You're Pee-wee Herman.
Well, I can't give away what my real name
no,
is.
No, what's your real name?
No, I can't give it away.
No, I really can't because
well, what does the P stand for?
Well, Pee-wee is just a nickname.
Oh, so it's not P period wee Herman.
No. No.
All these years, I thought it was Pee-wee Herman, but it's not. It's Pee-wee Herman.
Well, duh, David.
Yeah.
So aren't you going to open your present?
Pee-wee as in diminutive.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is very nice, Pee-wee, and I will open it.
Take a little longer to open it up?
No, I'll get right to it.
It's a cool present, my sister made it especially for you.
Well, that's very nice.
I just said that a minute ago.
Deja vu.
I hope you like it.
This is very nice. This is nice. This is
Yeah,
can't see it.
Oh, I see it. A tissue dispenser, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you can use it for a lot of things. You know, like,
No, that's beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah.
You don't see craftsmanship like this anymore.
No.
Yeah, it's beautiful. No. We'll put this right over here. We'll leave this on our set, and if any of our guests need a tissue, I'll be able to offer them one out of that head right over there.
Great. I gotta show you one thing here that because you mentioned that I was just in Minneapolis, and this is this newspaper from Minneapolis. It's a, you know, like, it tells what's happening in Minneapolis and stuff like that. And it has these ads in the back. You know, you've seen these kind of things. It says eligibles, you know, like for, you know, to meet people. Listen, I want to read you this ad because I just do. So listen to this.
If you are not afraid of commitment, and if you believe that relationships are, like everything else, worthwhile in life, requiring time and effort, then read on.
I'm a non-conventional, quality-oriented, handsome graduate student, 30, with eclectic and semi-bohemian tastes. Listen to this part. I'm sensitive, intelligent, sincere, loyal, and very nice. I seek a lovely, like woman, 24 to 30, for companion, significant other, and lasting relationship. Someone who responds to cinema, theater, cafe sitting, dance, Tom Waits, B.B. King, neon sculpture, Doctor Who, junk shops, neon sculpture, inner cities, unusual stuff, outrageous stuff, Pee-wee Herman. Look right there.
Pee-wee
Herman, this is an ad for somebody who's trying to find a girlfriend, and he wants somebody who likes Pee-wee Herman.
Yeah.
can you believe it? I can believe it.
Yeah. Well, now people are really beginning to...
You know, it's from your show, too. This guy made me right here. Me and David,
like this.
Now, how do you want to go over here, Pee-wee?
Yeah, we have this really swell special effect all set up, so you and me can go for a little cruise in the countryside, because, you know, I know you had to work on 4th of July,
right. I appreciate you coming by. We go over there now?
Yeah.
We go over there now?
Yeah, we just go over right now. You have to go on this side, because I'm going to drive.
Should I bring the tissues, Pee-wee, in case we have an accident in the car?
So if you just sit down, and here's
lovely.
The rest. Okay,
late
here we
model
go.
Sedan here.
Here we go now. Here we go. Peel out! Peel out!
So, anyway, I just wanted to tell you this one thing, because we were going along the other day, you know, and so I was like, you know, trying to figure this thing out. I was like talking about this joke and everything, and I couldn't figure it out or anything, what was going on or anything, so this guy's right on my butt.
Okay. Is that an Edsel, Pee-wee?
I don't know. Here, let's see how he likes this. Look. Windshield up! Just kidding, okay.
David, take the wheel!
You better drive, Pee-wee.
99 bottles of beer on the wall, 99 bottles of beer, a take from that.
It's sort of bumpy in the road, too, have you noticed
that? Yeah, it is a little bumpy.
Look out, pothole! Here comes another one, a big giant puddle!
Hey, could you take the wheel again? I'm kind of feeling a little car sick.
I tell you
right
what, we'll look. Pee-wee and I are going to go look for a good price on unleaded. While we do that, you take a look at this. We'll be right back. Welcome back. back to the program, ladies and gentlemen. Pee-wee Herman is here, and Marv Albert will be
David!
Playing.
David!
And also, David, P.J. O'Rourke will be joining.
David!
Could I have a Kleenex, Pee-wee? Is there?
Hello, Mr. Letterman.
Your stuff all over your suit. How do you like being in New York City for the 4th of July?
I really like it, but except I haven't seen any fireworks or anything.
Yeah, it'll be tonight. They'll start tonight.
Yeah, they generally shoot them off at night.
Yeah. And how you mentioned your family earlier. How are they doing?
They're doing great. Everybody's doing great. You know, I wanted to tell you this other thing, too, because I'm playing in this club in New York now, and called Caroline's, and they have a lot of food there and everything, so I have to wear this thing, because when we're playing around with food and stuff, the health department has these laws, so they make me wear this thing on the thing, and I do it. And so it looks sort of spazzy, don't you think?
It doesn't look that bad. It doesn't look too bad, no.
No, well, yeah. These things could come back, you know? I mean, like the kind with the beads and stuff on it could, you know, but then maybe they won't, too. I got something else I want to show you, too, that's a cool thing, because, see, this went over great in Minneapolis, because this is made in Minneapolis,
right there,
Scotch tape, Minneapolis. And this is a thing, thanks, okay, this is a thing that's called Fun with Tape, and you can play around with tape if you don't have anything to do at home. You could take, like, a piece of tape like this, and you can make it go like this, like... You could do a thing like this, and then you could take another piece of it like this if you want, and you could do this. Say like this. You could do a lot of stuff with it if you want.
Yeah.
You can do like stuff like this.
Hello. Hey, my twin brother!
I was just kidding.
Yeah, I know.
But, you know there's a lot of fun stuff you could do playing with this, and, you know.
I think kidnappings. You see a lot of that in kidnappings
sometimes. Yeah, then you could just, you know, take it off, like, you know.
All right. Now you have some one other thing you're going to do for us. Is that correct, Pee-wee, tonight?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
we have to go away here for station identification. When we come back, we'll go over there. Pee-wee Herman will be right back. Thank you, Paul, and welcome back to the show. Tomorrow, Don King will be here, also millionaire philanthropist Percy Ross and comedian Bill Maher. Pee-wee Herman is here. You just finished at the Tyrone Guthrie Theater in Minneapolis.
And now I'm playing with my wheel-o.
Now, what kind of a show do you do when you go to the Tyrone Guthrie Theater? This is a legitimate big-time place, isn't it? Pee-wee?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a real big place. It's giant, 1,400 seats.
But this is a legitimate theater, isn't it?
Yeah, well it is till I get there.
Uh-huh. And what sort of a show do you put on for the
Well, folks? I just, you know, I do stand-up comedy. I just go out and act funny.
Uh-huh.
Hey, I got something I got to show you right now. This is a fun toy. So see this little monster guy right here?
Yes.
You pull this thing out like this. And you probably, if you know about this, don't give it away. Look, can you get this on the camera right here? Look.
Okay, shut up. Why don't you have a heart attack?
Okay, look. I want to show you this too. Can you get a little closer on this thing so we can see it real close? Look inside here at this little fish swimming around.
Uh-huh, that's
la,
cute.
La, 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 la.
Okay.
Oh, that's it? No, oh, I'm sorry. I thought there was... Let me see that, Pee-wee.
You don't have to apologize.
No, okay. I thought something else was going to happen.
Well,
although this is certainly plenty.
Yeah,
I mean,
look through this.
It was good enough for the folks at the Arlo or at the...
Arlo Guthrie!
Guthrie Theater.
Look through this, Mr. Letterman. You can see a naked girl in here. Look in there. You just look in there and...
View artist models for men only. For best view, hold close. No, I know. This would put a silly little mark on my head, wouldn't it? Here, you try it.
No,
I'll try it.
Okay,
look with it.
Mm-hmm.
No, you got the wrong end.
Wait, I gotta do one more thing before I leave because I've been rehearsing and everything for it. I'm going to be making a surfing movie pretty soon.
You have this lint all over you.
I know. What's that right there?
I've been working out on the trampoline lately because I'm getting myself in shape because I'm going to be doing this surfing movie pretty soon. So I don't know too many stuff yet, but I know two tricks, so I was going to do a little trampoline
I'd love
for
to
you.
See them, sure.
Great. Well, I'm going to go right over to the trampoline.
All right, be careful.
Right now. I will.
Pee-wee Herman on the trampoline, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay. And now I have... Come right out on there. These are my spotters that were just selected from the audience. So if you could just take your positions around the trampoline, and this is my trampoline act right now. So you know you just gotta watch out. Just you know like spot me, okay? You know, in case like I start like flying off the trampoline or anything. Okay, so here's the trampoline act. I have to get up here so I don't brain myself. Okay, now if you're just completely quiet here, okay? Because this is pretty difficult for me. Knee drop! Seat drop! Need a seat! Okay, no, don't applaud, I flubbed it up.
That was amazing.
Thank you,
folks. Truly amazing demonstration. Pee-wee Herman, we'll be right back, folks. Very nice.
Let me cheer you folks up. You sound like you're a little down. I'm not sure exactly what it is my first guest does, but we're always happy to have him do it here. Please welcome back to the show, Pee-wee Herman.
Okay, hi everybody. Okay, I wanted to start out tonight by telling everybody a joke because I don't know very many jokes and I hardly ever tell one, so I'm gonna tell one right now, okay?
Okay,
so this guy, he's sleeping, and while he's sleeping, he has this dream because that's when you dream when you're sleeping, okay? So. So he's dreaming, he's having this dream, and he dreams that he kills a deer. Okay, so that's the only bad part of the joke. Okay, so he kills his deer. So wait. Okay, shut up. Okay, so when he wakes up, he goes, boy, I dreamed I killed a deer. This must mean something pretty heavy. So he decides he's going to go out and go deer hunting for real. So he gets up and he you know puts on his clothes and stuff and he goes out into his garage and he gets his gun and he puts it in his station wagon that kind of you know has wood panel stuff on the sides and he gets into it and he pushes the garage door opener and he goes out and he's on the street and he's driving along. Then he's driving along and he drives way, way out into the woods, okay? So he gets out into the woods and he parks his car in this clearing and... La, 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 and he walks way out into the woods. Well, pretty soon he's walking way out through the woods. And when he gets way out into the woods, he sees this clearing, another clearing, and he looks. And way across the clearing, he sees a deer. Way across the clearing, he sees a deer. So he decides he's gonna... Wait, forget all that. I forgot to tell you something right at the beginning of the joke. I didn't really forget to tell you anything. Okay, so he's at the clearing and he sees a deer way across. So he sees a deer, so he takes his gun and he pulls his gun out and he blows the deer away. So he goes over to where he shot the deer and he takes the deer and he throws the deer over one shoulder and his gun over the other and... And he walks back way out through the forest till he gets back to the clearing. So when he gets back to the clearing where his car is, he looks, and right against his car, he sees a big, huge, forest ranger standing there. So he sees the forest ranger, and the forest ranger standing up against his car, and the forest ranger goes, "Hey, buddy!" And the guy goes, "Yeah?" And he goes, "Hey, buddy!" And the guy goes, "Talking to me? You talking to me? You talking to me? And he goes, "Yeah, buddy, I'm talking to you!" And he goes, "Yeah, well, so what do you want?" And he goes,
"Hey, buddy, can you read?"
And the guy goes, "Yeah, I can read."
And he goes, "Well, can you read that billboard right there?"
That was the billboard right in back of the car. And he goes, "Yeah, I can read the billboard." And he goes, "Well, read it then." And the guy goes, "Okay, I will." And he goes,
"Okay, then read it."
And he goes, "Okay, I'm getting ready to." So he goes, "Okay, I'll read it." So he reads it and it says, "No deer hunting allowed ever." And so he goes, "Yeah, so?" And the forest ranger goes,
"Well, what's that over your shoulder then?"
And the guy goes, "My gun." And he goes, "No, buddy, the other shoulder." And the guy goes,
"Ah! Ah! Ah! Ah!" Nice to see you. Have a seat there. Pee-wee Herman, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back to talk with Pee-wee after you take a look at this talk. Thank you, folks. Thank you very much. Pee-wee, nice to have you back.
Thanks. Hey, Mr. Letterman, I mean Dave. I brought you a pirate hat if you want to put it on or anything.
Okay,
or you can,
maybe
you know,
a little later.
Wait till Halloween or anything.
Well, that's, yeah. No, I'll...
Hey,
we'll save that for Halloween.
Give him a break, okay? He doesn't want to put it on.
Thank you.
Look, I got a camera. I was going to show you this. I got this new camera. Look, yeah. I can take a picture like this. Look. Look. Mm-hmm.
That's nice. It's a gun and a
camera.
Yeah,
if the FBI ever comes, you just go like, "What gun?"
Yeah.
You do that.
Do you get the sense that the FBI may be following you?
Well, sometimes, you know, you know, you can't be too careful
about
really
the can't.
FBI, you know?
Yeah, you
know, body inspectors.
Are you having a nice summer, Pee-wee? Did
you
enjoy yourself?
I've been having a great summer, you know, because of this show. I've been having a great summer because so many people have been watching it, you know, and everything that out in Hollywood now, there's like, you know, what we call a buzz, you know, about me going on out there, you know. In fact, I was at this meeting the other day because I've been, you know, taking a lot of meetings and stuff. Yeah. And these people were looking at some tapes. And they were looking at some tapes of you and me, you know, from your show. And they were going like, you know, maybe this guy, David Letterman, would be the perfect person to team you up with. Really, I swear, they were saying this whole stuff. So, you know, I mean, if you want it, it's there, I think,
okay,
in the future.
Well,
because, you know, if I get it, you know, you're in.
Oh, thank you.
I do.
Very nice of you.
Really.
Hollywood because it would be great.
Now, you mentioned Hollywood. Do you live in Hollywood, Pee-wee?
Yeah, I live in Hollywood and in a house.
Yeah. And your folks, or where do
my
they
folks,
live?
Folks, they're living not in Hollywood. They live in another city because, uh-huh. I guess...
Well,
you
I
know,
got an idea why.
Well...
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
It's okay. Hey, your epidermis is showing. You know what? I found out right before the show, you're not supposed to wear white shoes after Labor Day. I just found that out today, tough break for me. Because,
you know, but they don't look bad on you. They look good on you.
Thanks. Hey,
stare contest!
You looked away.
Yeah.
You looked away.
Yeah. Maybe I would be the perfect one to team up with you, Pee-wee.
Look at these. Look at this. Watch this.
Hi, I'm from England.
We got to pause here for station identification. We'll call the NBC lawyers. Richard Lewis will be here, also a gentleman who runs a school for butlers, Ivor Spencer. Our guest tonight is Pee-wee Herman, also a little bit later, Jim Moran will be out here. Do you know Jim Moran? Have you ever seen him?
No.
Very interesting guy. You should stick around and watch it.
I will, in the green room.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, I was going to do a magic trick for you right now, because, you know, I'm trying a lot of new stuff I haven't ever done. I haven't done magic, so I have this magic wand, you know, look.
Oh, that's nice.
So magic. So here's the magic trick. Now, if you just pay very close attention, I just have to say the words abracadabra, cadabra, cadabra. Magic now will happen, cadabra.
Wow, that's very impressive.
Ow! Magic now, fire away!
That's great. You're coming right along.
I have something else set up over here. If you wanna play something with me, I have some game kind of stuff you can play. You know, like if it's raining a lot, you know.
Rainy day fun kind of thing.
Yeah.
You want me to come over there with you?
Yeah. All right. It's rainy day fun. Rainy day fun, and all you need for this rainy day fun here.
Boy, that's a handsome suit, Pee-wee. Yeah. Every time you're on,
thanks a lot. It's a kind of suit. I'm not sure where this is exactly supposed to go. Does this have a place where it has to go for?
That looks good.
Okay. So here's what you play now.
Can I help you with anything?
Card table. Yeah. If you want, you could just take all this stuff and just throw it on the floor like that, right there.
Okay. We do at home.
Yeah.
All right.
And then. But not this. No. You can set this up though if you want, because this is your camp chair, and you can set it up right over here and sit in it, because that's a...
Camping with Pee-wee. That's
a
like a headline.
Camping
that's like a headline in the Post, isn't it?
Then what you do is... So you remember this when you would play when you were little? You get sheets like this and put it over the table, and then you could make a fort like this? Do you remember? Do you remember this?
Yeah.
Okay, so you could just sit down right here, because now we're going to play in this thing right here. So I just have to, you know, get all the toys over here to play camping
all right.
in here.
Now, you just want me to sit down here, Pee-wee?
Yeah! You can sit right out there! So you can play... You could play right in here like this. Remember this kind of candy?
No, I never seen that before.
This is this kind of candy right here. You could. I like to eat this kind of candy, you know, because you can eat like, you know, it's real little when you eat it. You know, you can eat it like this. pink.
Yeah.
Yellow.
Pretty much the same procedure for all the colors, then,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah. I swallowed a piece of paper, though.
Pee-wee,
Hey, look!
Uh-oh, butts, no.
Cigarettes, you can smoke it in here, because... But you shouldn't smoke, so I won't. But, look! Thanks!
Pee-wee, I hate to interrupt your camping fun, but I think somebody's at the door. I'll just go answer the front door.
Okay,
You stay here in your playroom,
okay,
all right?
Okay, all right. Tell them hi.
Yeah, okay.
Hey,
and anytime you want to get out of there, it's fine with me.
Hey, somebody's at the door. So, here's what you do mainly when you're playing in this thing is, you know, read like, you know, Playboy magazines. With a flashlight, you can read the Playboy magazines and stuff like that. Or you can play like with wild animals, you know, going like, and you can eat more candy if you want. Because I forgot, I didn't eat. Green, blue. So anyway, that's green. that's green. Green and blue.
I had to come over here because I didn't know exactly what you were going to do there.
Oh, well, you
didn't mind me leaving, did you?
No, not at all. In fact, I wanted to show you a little toilet humor right here because look at this toilet right here.
Yeah, that's,
look what's inside of it.
Well, why don't you just open it up?
Okay, look. And look, I have this toilet too. It's a radio.
Yeah.
You can turn it on. See that? That's it. That's all. Yeah, that doesn't really work too good.
Well, those are both nice items.
And look, little
Pee-wee sized toilet. Uh-huh. Look. Hello, everyone.
Yeah, that's great.
And I have this thing too. Like, look, Smurf, look.
So you travel with all this stuff.
Yeah, but I don't like playing with this too much because it's, you know, too Smurfy kind of.
Yeah. Two or three hours of that, you probably get bored, don't you?
Yeah. Okay, so do we have enough time now to go to this next thing? Okay, so I wanted to show you this one other thing real quick because, you know, I have a hobby. I don't know if you know this, but I collect tin foil.
Uh-huh.
And I've been doing it for about 5 years now, and I have this ball, and it's bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And I wanted you to come over here and take a look at it because it's...
Tin foil ball.
Yeah, people send me...
What about the tent here? You've messed up the living room.
Easy enough, just... set and forget.
Okay. Nope.
So come on over here. I just want you to, you know, just stand right here, and I'm going to show you this ball. And keep in mind, this ball started as a little tiny ball this big, okay?
Okay.
Well, take a look at this
ball,
now.
Because... a little tiny ball.
Glow head or go down a dark tunnel or anything, you know, when people like, you know, almost get run over and stuff, sometimes they, you know, see like, you know, remember that movie like Beyond and Back, you know, and they were, you know, see a glow head down at the end of the tunnel.
No, that didn't happen. But I could use a drink.
Come on.
Pee-wee, nice to see you again.
Okay.
Have a nice day in New York. We'll be right back, folks, to take a look at some international symbols. Halloween is a very special time, speaking of Halloween, for my next guest. We're always excited and more than a little apprehensive when he's on our program. Please welcome now Pee-wee Herman.
David.
So, you must be pretty excited about Halloween, huh?
Yeah, I'm real excited. Hey, trick or treat, smell my feet, give me something good to eat. Yeah, I was out trick-or-treating tonight. I really raked in the candy corn today, too. Like,
wow.
Candy corn.
Yeah.
Did you see my hook hand? Look.
I noticed that, sure.
Look, guess what I am?
Yeah, you're a pirate.
Right, a pirate.
I thought for a minute there'd been an accident in shop class when I saw that.
Hey, Dave, I got a really lot of cool Halloween stuff, too, for Halloween. Look, I got this thing right here. It's called I Want to Bite Your Finger. And it's a really cool toy. Look, you stick your finger right in there.
Uh-huh. Do you want me to stick my finger?
Yeah, just stick your finger right in there. I promise, nothing will happen. No, from there, from the front.
From this side.
Yeah. La, la, la. Okay, look, take it out now. Look, you have a little two holes of red blood on your finger.
Wow. This is a valuable piece of equipment.
Yeah,
sure.
I wouldn't believe what this little baby set me back.
Yeah, uh-huh. Well worth every penny, though.
And I have this really cool toy. My friend Christian gave me this, and he would only loan it to me if I told his name on TV. Uh-huh. So, are you satisfied? So, look at all the stuff this does. Look, there's a scary... Can you get in closer on this? Because look, a scary kitty right there. Look, see the ghost right there at the window? There's a ghost at the window. See him?
Oh, my.
Look. Look now, this is the scariest part. Look at the roof now.
Yeah.
The whole house, can you believe it?
Well, it's certainly easy to see why your friend wanted credit for that.
I wanted to show you this today because somebody made this for me on the road when I was just touring on my big, mini national tour that I was just doing. And this thing, I don't know if you can see, there's you right up in the corner, see?
I'm in there?
Yeah, look on the screen. See, you're sitting at the desk.
Yep.
And here's me, and I'm on your show doing my dance. Look. Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, that's very nice.
It has my name on it, though, and I'm a lot bigger than you in here, you know, because you're kind of teeny up
there.
There's
a little message back here. It says, Dear P.
That's right.
Yeah, dear... Hey, look at you doing a big shoe dance on the show.
On the Letterman show. Yeah. Look, your name right there.
But
Letterman.
I like this Dear P. I think that's...
Why don't you marry it? Okay. I'm so excited about it being Halloween.
Are you really?
Anyway, because, yeah, I brought this in case you wanted to have silver hair tonight.
Maybe later.
How about if I clean your contact lenses?
No.
Yeah, I got two. Look, here's Casper. Look.
Oh, that's cute. Yeah, that's
really nice. Yeah, you can make him talk.
Hi, I'm Casper.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah.
He's Casper.
Okay, Pee-wee, I tell you what, we got to go away here. When we come back, you're going to do some other things for Halloween?
Yeah, boy.
Oh, okay. We'll be back, folks, with Pee-wee Herman. This is Pee Wee Herman, and did you ever participate in the holiday of Halloween to any extent?
Oh, yeah. Halloween's always been my favorite holiday. I love Halloween. I'm not going to marry it, though, but because Halloween's a time when you can, dress up in scary costumes and look real weird and be real weird, and people don't even care. They don't even give it a second thought.
Yeah.
I was walking up here tonight in this costume, and people were just going, oh, big deal,
Yeah, that's right. In some neighborhoods, that wouldn't attract any attention, I guess.
That's right, David. Hey, Dave, put these cool glasses on, right, and you'll look different, too.
Let's put these, slip into these glasses. I hope these have been boiled.
It's a big spider. Mm. Along came a spider and sat down beside her and said, "Hi, baby, what you got in the bowl?" Look, a brain.
Oh, a brain.
Hey, we got this really cool effect set up, David. It's kind of a Halloween thing, you know, a special Halloween thing, so
sure.
That we can look different ways, you know, like disguise kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That thing's just about to drop off your nose, is that?
Oh, no! Oh! Oh, big mole! Oh!
I didn't really eat it. I gotta show you this cool effect, though, because I think if you look that way and then I look this way, then we can do this thing where we can make each other look really spazzy.
All right,
stuff.
Which way am I supposed to look?
I think right there.
Right here, okay,
yeah.
I'll look here.
And then I look this way right here.
Uh-huh.
And look, you won't believe what we're gonna do right
now. I can't see what we're doing.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the show.
Oh, this is me, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh.
It's like discount plastic surgery.
We can do it with the eyes, too, with our eyes, too. I can make my eyes go right on your face, too.
Okay.
Too, look.
Well, that's certainly plenty
they
of fun.
They haven't done it yet, though. Uh-oh.
Doesn't seem to work here.
Yeah, just hold still. Hold real still.
Okay. This is what American television is all about, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
That was enjoyable.
That was the most fun I've had in a while. Yeah, I got these cool Halloween glasses, too, uh-huh. If you want to put these on there. Pumpkin jack-o'-lantern glasses.
No, I don't. Well, it's pretty much putting the other glasses on, isn't it?
Yeah, but different.
You have kind of a deal with an optician, apparently, don't you?
Yeah. Well, it's kind of the same as putting the other glasses on, only crunchy.
Yeah, only.
Yeah, they're from TV.
I don't get it.
I got some other cool junk, too. I got an E.T. finger that lights up.
Okay, all right, we got to do this again. We're going away for station identification, but when we come back, you can... show us your light-up finger.
Okay.
We'll be right back, folks. Pee-wee Herman is still with us. Elizabeth Ashley will be joining us. Frank Zappa is here tonight. Tomorrow on the show, Bob and Ray. You're a big Bob and Ray fan.
Oh, God, right? Love them.
Yeah, they will be here. Also, cartoonist Mark Stamati. Am I pronouncing that name correctly? Stamati. He'll be here tomorrow. And you're still here, as I mentioned before.
I'm still here!
Dave, look, I got these real cool Halloween tattoos. I was going to give you this bat. That tattoo right
kids,
here.
Kids love tattoos, don't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, I love tattoos. Yeah. I love tattoos.
But, see, you put this on right here, and then you put the sponge on top, and you have to apply a little bit of pressure.
I thought it was done with some sort of a hot needle or something, but...
Yeah, well, I've got the hot needles here if you'd rather have the hot needles.
Well, maybe later at the party.
Later at the big cool party?
Yeah,
the big cool Halloween party.
Yeah,
I guess my phone must have been off the hook when you called me.
Yeah, probably was.
That one, yeah.
Uh-oh. Oh, no! Oh! Oh, scary.
Brother.
Scary.
Now, how long will it take to get this off of there?
Oh, that'll be off by the time you go into your fourth season.
Now, what if I run into a fat guy on the train tonight and he asks me about this tattoo?
You could just sock him in the face and then it'll be on his cheek.
Pretty good
Dick,
idea.
How would you like to go with me right now to a haunted mansion?
All right, I'd love that.
Come on. Come on.
Haunted mansion.
Yeah, it's gonna be really scary and everything, too, because it's
the haunted mansion where a scary mad scientist lives.
And we're gonna go right over here, okay?
We're gonna go to the haunted mansion.
Yeah, it's right back up in there. It's right back and back
haunted
of the gate.
Mansion.
No, but don't be scared of it, because we have to go through the graveyard.
Come on now. Let's go through. Oh, gee, look! Zombies! There's zombies back there! No!
Zombies back there now.
Maybe we should crouch down a little bit.
No, I think if we just stand direct, we probably have a better chance of scaring the zombies off.
It's too scary here.
Look at the zombies, Dave. The zombies don't sleep in. There's the mad scientist's house right up there.
Uh-huh.
Come on. Come on, Dave. Come on. Going up to the mad scientist's chamber.
Yeah, this is the place.
Right in here. Scary in here.
Yeah. Yeah, it really is. Now, what is this? Do that again.
Okay.
Oh, brother.
Look, I'm going to mix up a special potion, Dave.
Uh-huh.
La la la. Mm-hmm. Dash of this. No, 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 no. No. Dave! Dave!
Yeah, you are in doubt, huh?
Yeah.
Well, that's good. You certainly had us worried there for a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, now we've seen that.
Yeah, well, you could look at this, too. Look, put your hand under here, and you could see something real big.
Well, this would be good for viewing the new tattoo, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Look!
Yeah. Well, that's exciting.
Yeah.
I hope the mad scientist doesn't come back. But would you like to drink some potion, Dave?
No, that's all right.
Are you sure? This one's raspberry flavor. Jack-o'-lantern flavor.
You want to have a little of this?
Sure.
Hope it doesn't turn you into a monster, though.
It's not too bad. Not too bad.
I'll see you in the basement.
Pee-wee, have a happy Halloween.
Thanks
for being
here.
My first guest tonight was just, oh, maybe you saw this gentleman, New Year's Eve. He was a reporter on the MTV broadcast, their New Year's Eve show, and his own special will be reappearing on HBO in February. We're always sort of delighted to have him with us. Please welcome Pee-wee Herman.
Have a heart attack. Okay, I got a joke to start out New Year's with, okay? Okay, all right. There's this guy, all right, and he's looking through the want ads for a job, you know, because, you know, 1983 wasn't the greatest year in the world for jobs, you know, duh. So he is looking for this job, and I forgot to tell you one thing. The guy doesn't have any arms, okay? Doesn't have any arms. So, you know, he's looking through the newspaper, you know, like this. And he finally finds this one job, and the job says, wanted,
energetic young man to ring bell in church. So the guy goes,
hey, I can ring the bell in the church.
So he goes way over to the church. He walks up to the front door of the church. He bangs his head on the door. And the priest comes to the door. And the priest goes,
yes, my son?
And the guy goes,
Father, I've come to ring the bell.
And the guy goes, yeah, but kid, you don't have any arms, so how could you ring the bell? And the guy goes, duh, Father, don't you think I would have thought of that before I came over here and applied? Where's the bell? I'll ring it. And the guy, and the priest goes, okay, you'll have to prove you can ring it. And he goes, okay, so where's the bell? And we ring it. So they go way up to the top of the bell tower. It's four flights of stairs up, and there's no escalator or anything. You know, they have to go up the, you know, spiral staircase, and they feel like barfing and stuff. And then they get wet. They get way up to the top, and there's this big bell sitting there. So the priest goes, okay, so ring the bell. So the guy backs way up like this, and the bell's like right up there. The guy backs way up like this. He starts running face first right towards the bell. He rings, bang! He bangs his face right into the bell, and the bell goes, bong! So the priest can't believe it. The priest is standing there like this. So he can't even believe it. And he goes, well, you rang the bell, so I guess you can have the job. So the guy goes, yay, 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 yay! Got the job. So everything is going great for about 3 months. About 3 months goes by, and every day this guy climbs up four flights of stairs 12 times a day. He has to go up and ring the bell. So every time he goes up, he gets way back like this. He runs right down the... Bang! Bong! So... after 3 months goes by, I mean, the guy looks like a pancake, you know? His face is all wrecked up and all ugly and stuff, but he doesn't care because he's raking in the big dough, you know? So he doesn't care. So 3 months have gone by. One day, he's going up. It's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so he's already rang the bell a lot of times that day. So... just like he always does, he backs up like this, and he's getting ready to do it, and he starts to run right towards the bell, but he trips. He falls right past the bell, right out the window, four stories down, creamed all over the cement. So this big crowd of people is gathering all around him, and this one guy crouches down like this, and he's cradling the guy's head in his arms because the guy's all smashed up all over the sidewalk. And this big fat lady's right here, and she's going, who is it? Who is it? Who fell from the bell tower? And this guy who's down here cradling the guy, he looks up at her and he goes,
I don't know his name, but his face rings a bell.
But his face rings a bell.
Do you get it?
Yeah, I get it.
Hey, Dave, next one to speak's a monkey for a week.
Pee-wee, I saw you on the... Yeah,
hi, monkey.
Yeah. I heard about your show, the MTV show.
New Year's. Yeah, Happy New Year.
Same to you.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, it was real exciting. I got to see all the big stars, the Stray Cats, and, you know, all those guys.
Yeah.
Well,
what did they have you doing over there?
They had me down on the floor in the party, you know, with all these people, like, you know, drunk and drinking champagne and going crazy. And I was, you know, down there going like,
oh, hi, it's me down at the party, you know.
And that was crazy.
Yeah. Did you get paid a lot of money for that?
No, I didn't get paid any money for it.
Really?
No.
Well, that stinks. No. That's no good.
Yeah, zip, zero, zilch, zally, nothing. But you should see, it was worth it because you would have believed the toys I raked in for Christmas.
You got some nice things?
Oh, I got so many cool toys, I can't even believe it.
It's always my favorite part when you bring the toys in.
I got this book, Part-Time Boy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's really good reading. I haven't read it yet, but it's good. And look, I got this Christmas card. Listen.
Elizabeth T. Billington, listen. Part-Time Boy. That's cute. That's very nice. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
I got this ray gun. That's a ray gun. I got a whole bunch of E.T. stuff, too. Uh-huh. E.T. Christmas, I got this.
Yeah.
This E.T. Hello. Hi, Elliot. Hi.
I got that
Pee-wee,
one.
Pee-wee.
Yeah.
That's
my name.
You?
Don't wear it out.
we have to go away here for a commercial.
Okay.
But we'll be right back, and Pee-wee has plenty of stuff to show us, so. I didn't mean to interrupt you. You had another E.T. doll here. This stuff's about a year old, isn't it?
Yeah, that's why I got a lot of it for Christmas, you know, because it's a year old, so you get it cheap, you know.
You mark it down and then move it right
out. Got this E.T. finger, you know. Remember this commercial? Remember?
When even tying a simple knot becomes a painful...
Yeah, this is the coolest thing I got, though. I got these stars. Look.
I pity the poor man who called me a fool.
Yeah, I got little Mr. T and big Mr. T.
And look right here. Look. Hello.
That's Nancy Reagan.
Nancy Reagan,
Nancy
sure.
You know, I gotta show you one other thing, Dave, that I got because this is so cool. This, I thought I'd bring this because...
Looks like
some kind of
an electrical device
here. It's called the sizzling skillet. And you make junk out of Play-Doh like this. See, I made this cheeseburger right here.
Yeah.
And then you can make this kind of junk, too. I'll show you. You can make French fries like this. You just, like, crank them out. See?
There they are.
They won't come out. But we got this cheeseburger here. And then you put this thing in like this. Look.
Right in the skillet. Look.
That's great.
Yeah, it makes... Ow! I've been spattered. I'll just flip it over.
Ow! Yeah, and then...
that's the sizzling skillet.
That's terrific.
Yeah.
You got some lovely... You made out like a bandit. This
Yeah. Week. Want some candy?
Yeah, what do you have there?
Open your mouth.
give me another shot here.
It's empty. It's okay. I could have knocked his teeth out or something.
Probably been a help.
Yeah.
Disappointed the kids, Pee-wee.
Yeah, look at this one, too.
You know, the kids look up to you, and you broke their little hearts tonight.
Yeah. Got a lot of that stuff. You know what? Have you heard about this new fad, breakdancing?
Sure.
Yeah.
We had some breakdancers on here a few months ago.
You
did? Yeah, last summer.
Well, guess what? I've been practicing my breakdancing.
No, you?
Yeah. Want to see some breakdancing?
You want to do it for us?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I have to go over here and do my breakdancing. This is kind of a new twist on breakdancing, okay? So I'm going to just start out right now.
You say a one for the trouble, two for the time. Come on, y'all, let's break this.
They call it breakdancing, you know, because it'll break anything, so, you know.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice job.
Thanks, I thought it out myself.
Now, where are you going to be next, Pee-wee? If folks around the country would like to come and see you in person, where will you be?
Nowhere.
Okay. thanks for starting the new year
with us.
Thank
you. Happy New Year.
Pee-wee Herman, folks. We'll be back in 4 seconds.
Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
I just want you to know, I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay. A Coke and a smile makes me feel good.
Makes me feel nice. Be around. That's the way it should be. I like to see.
Hey,
the whole world is smiling with me. Coca-Cola has life. Have a Coke and
thanks, Mean Joe.
Smile.
We're out of time. My thanks to Pee-wee Herman tonight. Joe, good luck to you. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure meeting you. Nice having you here, sir. We'll see you tomorrow night, folks. Steve Sweeney and Marv Albert will be here. Have a good night and a good year. Bye-bye, folks.
Here, kid.
Thanks, Joe!
Welcome back to the program, ladies and gentlemen. We got a great show for you tonight. We're going to be catching fish like crazy minutes from now, so wake the kids and phone the neighbors. My first guest needs no introduction, though he obviously needs something. He will be appearing at the Park West in Chicago, June 14th and 15th. Then, listen to this, Paul, pretty impressive stuff here, at Carnegie Hall, June 20th and 21st, and then at the Universal Amphitheater in Los Angeles, June 29th. Please welcome back to this program, Mr. Pee-wee Herman. Boy, it's great to see you again, Pee-wee. Let me ask you about this piece of jewelry. You didn't have that the last time you were here.
No, it's a big, giant ruby ring. It came with this. See, can you read that right there?
What does it say? Mr. T.
Mr. Is what T! It's
Mr. T jewelry. It's Mr. T jewelry.
It looks very nice.
Yeah, and I got this cool cosmic band-aid, too, right here.
Did you cut yourself?
Yeah, I cut myself on a rusty nail.
Did you get it? Did you get it?
That was a lockjaw joke.
Yeah. Now you should always get a tetanus shot.
Tetanus shot always and Bactine, too.
Yeah,
spread.
Get a little Bactine. Let me ask you about this, Pee-wee. Do you mind if I call you Pee?
Call me anything you like.
Park West in Chicago. Is that a big place? How many seats there?
I think that's about 1,500 seats.
Ooh, yeah.
All right. Now, Carnegie Hall. Very, very impressive.
Mm-hmm.
And then Universal Amphitheater. Those are two very impressive venues, as we say in the business.
Yeah, I'm impressed.
Yeah.
Would you care for some more?
Well, why don't you describe what those are for people?
Well, these are s'mores, are Girl Scout food. See, my sister told me about this before. See, what you're supposed... See, hear the girls laughing out there? They're the ones. They know. See, if you have a sister like I do, then and she was a Girl Scout, then you know about s'mores. It's melted marshmallows. These...
I've chosen the little peewee size ones.
And you're supposed to melt them, you know? If you're a Girl Scout, you're supposed to always be next to a campfire.
Yeah.
And then you put...
You are!
Then you put the chocolate on top and then the sandwich it in with some graham crackers.
Yeah.
Like that.
But you're supposed to melt that up a little, right?
Yeah, you're supposed to, sure. But we didn't have any campfires around.
Maybe so. A little later. I'll try
maybe.
Maybe. What is your sister's name? You mentioned you had a sister.
Yeah, I have a sister named Hermione Herman.
Hermione Herman.
Yeah, yeah. My mom's name's Honey Herman. My dad's name's Herman Herman. Everyone in the family's name begins with an H except me.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're Pee-wee.
Hmm? I love that story.
Hey, I got a really cool toy to show you right here, Dave. Look.
Let me move the s'mores,
Pee-wee. This is...
Watch it,
Pee-wee. Watch out for your face!
And I have two other things I wanted to present you with as a little gift, you know. And this is one thing right here. Look.
Take a look at that.
Remember when I came on your show with my giant underpants?
You have your picture right here.
Yeah. Have my picture on it. Kind of one size fits all, more or less.
Pee-wee Herman souvenir giant underpants.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what are you getting for a pair of these?
$8.
Oh, my God. $8.
I'm rich.
All right. Did you like New Orleans?
Oh, I love New Orleans. Yeah. That's why I'm a little bit hoarse. I was going on the rides at the fair.
Oh, yeah, the World's Fair.
Yeah.
Light me.
No, I'm just kidding. They're chocolate.
Oh,
I see.
Do you
care for one?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, suit yourself.
Yeah, the fair was pretty cool.
Yeah.
I went on it. I was screaming so loud on those rides, and then I went on this one roller coaster. Did you see that one ride that looked like a giant couch that went up in the air?
Yeah, I did. I saw that.
Yeah, I went on that, and I threw up all over it. And it flew so far, and these people were sitting at a restaurant having gumbo, you know?
Yeah. Oh, gosh, I love that story.
Why don't you marry it?
Do you want to do your thing right here? Do you want to?
Yeah. Do we have enough time?
Well, let's find out. Do we have time? Okay.
Okay. I want to just set this up because, you know, when I came on the show a couple times ago, I did a lot of shoe kind of stuff. First, I had my big giant shoes.
Yeah.
And then I did my toe dancing shoes. Well, I was at my parents' house the other night, and I was trying to look around, see if I could come up with any more shoe stuff. And I have another shoe dance I wanted to just show you real quick, okay?
All right, sure.
Okay. Well,
right, Pee-wee Herman, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay. Just gotta put them on real quick. Mm-hmm. La, la,
mm-hmm. Okay. This is it, okay?
Hard to believe, huh?
Never know how much I love you.
Backwards!
Never know how much I love you. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever, when you hold me tight.
Pee-wee!
Pee-wee up through the night.
Pee-wee, I believe you're getting stranger. We have to do a commercial, and we'll be right back. Pee-wee handed me, I guess this is the most recent copy of the Pee-wee News. Pee-wee Press, I'm
just
sorry.
Just hot off the presses,
yeah. His picture, you here with Andy Warhol?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. pretty exciting.
Morgan? No, that's not Morgan Fairchild. Judy Landers.
Judy Landers, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, oh boy, you certainly get around.
Yeah.
But now, what else do you have for us tonight?
Well, I was gonna show you a little scene about this astronaut played by the star right here. See this star? Can you get in close on this star? Look right here.
Look at his eyes. La la.
And I thought I'd show you this guy on another planet if you wanted to work this guy, or else I can, you know?
All right, now.
All you have to do is just hold him and make him look like he's just, you know, hopping around, like looking at stuff. And if you want, you can just, you know, make his eyes go back and forth like that.
Okay, let me just say my policy on this is I generally don't like to call attention to myself by doing peculiar things.
Oh,
yeah, I know what you mean.
Okay.
Yeah. So anyway, so you just landed on this other planet.
Okay, now this is about.
Oh, you have a piece of fuzz in your hair. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
So, the first thing you see on the other planet is this guy right here. Watch his eyes. Look.
La la la. Ah! Ah! Ah!
Yeah.
Yeah. See, then you see that guy, and you're kind of scared, so you make him jump a little bit and go,
oh, oh no, oh no, oh no. Okay. Ow!
Then he bites your feet.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
No, that's that part. Then
a beautiful space woman comes up and says, hello. Aren't you Dave Letterman?
See, on the other planet, you sort of look like yourself, even though you don't really look anything like yourself.
Hello?
Okay. Then, for some reason, a horse comes up like that and goes, get that.
Then this scary guy comes up,
but you're not scared of him because he just squeaks. You know?
That's right. Sure.
Then this guy is here
and he's going. Hey, it is I, Oz, Mr. Oz. La 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 la. La 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 la. Then look. Oh no.
Yeah, that's
horrible. But in the very end, then there's a big egg sitting here, and you look at it and you go,
I wonder what's in the egg. And a monster! Another monster is in the egg.
Then I'm getting so excited about all this stuff. Then at the very end, in the nick of time, one of the guys in Menudo shows up. This is Charlie from Menudo.
Charlie, okay.
And he goes,
hi, Dave, can Menudo be on your show, huh? Can the? And then Charlie from Menudo goes, come on, Dave, come on. I'll show you the way home. And you go, la 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 la.
There we go.
The end.
Pretty impressive. All right, Pee-wee, now let's see, you're going to Chicago, then you're coming back here to New York, you're going to be at Carnegie Hall.
Yeah,
20th and 21st. Cool. Could I come and see you at Carnegie Hall?
Well, I don't know. Beg me!
No, I'd like for you to come.
I'd love to see you.
Yeah, I'd love for you to come. You know what? At Carnegie Hall and the Universal Amphitheater, we're doing it for Toys for Tots, too, so people come, they can bring toys, you know, any kind of toys that they want, and then, you know, we'll distribute them to kids.
You're not keeping them, you're distributing
them. No.
Okay.
I wouldn't keep them.
I'm not going to keep them.
All right, Pee-wee, good to see you again.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks for dropping by. Pee-wee Herman. We'll be back to do some top fishing. Halloween just wouldn't be complete without a trick-or-treat call from my first guest making his second annual Halloween appearance on our program. Please say hello to Mr. Pee-wee Herman.
Jeez, tonight. I have an awful headache.
Show business!
Ow! Ow!
Easy. You know, I never quite know when you're finished when you're on the show. So
I'm all finished.
Oh, you're all finished. Sure.
Yeah, to take my ears off because I can't hear too good with these ears.
Now the.
I'm a devil.
Now, the last time. The last time you were here, I think your costume was a little more elaborate last Halloween.
Yeah, well, this was kind of last minute. Last year I was a pirate, remember?
Yeah.
And this year I was going to be Prince. Right before the show, I decided I couldn't be Prince because I couldn't get a hold of all the junk that I needed, you know, ruffled shirt and, mm-hmm. you know.
I love that story.
So I had to do this right at the last minute and everything.
That's
but
good.
Look, how get it? Look. Yeah. La 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 la.
That's Devil with the Blue Dress. Uh-huh. Care for a devil egg? So, anyways, I was.
How you been?
I've been fine.
Yeah, good.
How about you?
Fine, just fine.
Good.
Nice to see you again.
Thanks. It's wonderful to be here on Halloween and everything. Gonna just make myself a quick little drink right here.
This is jack-o'-lantern ice. Yeah.
Can you believe it?
No.
You can't believe it.
La la la. Uh-oh.
Look, I got a whole bunch of cool candy and junk for Halloween. Look.
Hot dog gum. Hot dog gum.
Would you like a piece of hot dog gum?
No.
Can't interest you. How about a piece of chocolate?
No thanks.
Rubber chocolate!
Plus,
everyone's favorite, candy corn.
Candy corn,
Yeah. Yeah, and look at somebody gave me this. Batman credit card.
Batman credit card.
Yeah. So, anyway, I wanted to show you a bunch of Halloween junk, if that's okay.
Oh, I really don't think so, Pee-wee. No, sure. Whatever you have, we all...
Beg me now.
No. We all want to see what you have.
Well, are you familiar with Barbie magazine, Dave?
No, I didn't. I don't...
Barbie magazine has a big Halloween feature in it this month. It's just amazing. I don't know if you can see this or not here.
See, look, Barbie's Trick or Treat Adventure.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it has really funny junk in it, like this. Look, it says one of these dolls here, Barbie's friends going,
I wonder how a princess would wear her hair. And then Barbie says, guess what, Tracy? I just guessed your Halloween costume. Duh, Barbie.
So are you gonna get dressed up for Halloween or anything like that?
Have you ever had a date?
Yeah, you know who I had to turn a date down with tonight to come to New York and be on this show?
No.
I mean, you know, I mean, I was dying to come be on the show.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I wasn't dying, but, you know.
Yeah.
But you know who Elvira is? The movie vampire girl?
Yeah.
Yeah, me and her. Just like this.
Is that right?
Yeah, I'm on top.
we have to do a commercial here. We'll be right back with our friend... Pee-wee Herman is here, and later we have a woman, Pee-wee, who's She's an expert at speed boxing, hitting the speed bag. She's 84 sure. years old. Do you like boxing? Do you follow?
Yeah. Yeah, I follow it pretty good, but you know, I haven't done it or anything.
No, you never done boxing. Yeah. No. Yeah.
Speaking of boxing, you know, I just thought of this. Would you mind if I showed you my cool gremlin collection?
No.
Yeah, look, this is what made me think of it. Box, you know, I thought, box, gremlin cereal.
Yeah.
See, I have gremlin cereal right there.
Let me see that. Is that really good?
Gremlin. Oh, delicious.
This is from the hit movie, Gremlins.
Yeah. Yeah, look right on the back here. It says, star of the new movie presented by Steven Spielberg. Gets his name even on the gremlin cereal box. So,
That's big time
have this. Look, I have a bendable, posable one, you know, like, look,
hello, Mr. Letterman.
So I have that gremlin, and I have this little teeny gremlin, right there.
La, 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 la.
I have that one. Then I have this cool gremlin right here. Look what this one does.
La, 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 la. Gum! It's a gum detector.
Yeah. I chose an orange for Halloween.
Yeah,
that's the gremlin gum dispenser. And then I have gremlin candy.
Gremlin candy.
And then I have these gremlin things right here that you put in water and they grow big.
Oh, really? How big do they get?
They get, oh, we couldn't do it in here because studio's too shrimpy. So, then,
look!
That's the big gremlin.
So you got a lot of dough tied up here in your gremlin stuff.
Yeah,
huh?
I love my gremlin collection.
Uh-huh. What else you got? What do you now? Will you go to parties on Halloween?
Yeah, party hardy. Are you kidding? Yeah.
I'm
gonna party all night.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as I get done with the show and, you know, get my costume switched around and junk, you know, I'm gonna modify it a little bit for a party and stuff. But
You may need a checkup. Have you ever thought maybe it's time for a checkup?
Yeah, it might be.
Yeah.
Might be time for a checkup.
You know, now what kind of things will you do at a party? You know, so you're going to modify your costume there. What modifications would you?
Well, I'm going to bring a whole bunch of scary stuff to a party, so when I go in at the party, I can make people scared, you know, like make them, like, scare people, because I'm the devil and everything tonight. So.
Yeah, well, they'll be scared silly.
Yeah!
And, what sort of games will you
look at these. I forgot to show you these. Look, pumpkin seeds, jack-o'-lantern seeds right here. And look, I don't know if you can see this or not right here, but you plant these in the ground, and the jack-o'-lanterns come up just like this.
That's amazing.
I know. Can you believe it?
Yeah, it eliminates an awful lot of work after the big harvest, doesn't it?
Yeah. I got this devil camera, too. Look right here.
La, la. That's the devil camera.
That's the devil camera.
It's only a devil camera because it's red.
Yeah. Well, everything else was such a big hit, I wouldn't worry about that.
That's the devil squirt tongue.
All right. Now, we're out of time, Pee-wee.
No!
Yeah. It's time to go. Is there anything you want to mention before you leave us tonight?
Not really. Just like, you know, if you're out trick-or-treating tonight, don't eat any apples you can shave with.
Well put. Thank you very much, Peter.
Thank you.
We'll be right back after station identification. And I, by the way, will be in Lancaster, Pennsylvania toward the end of the month doing Brigadoon at the dinner theater there. Sound like they got together and made a family decision. We've seen the show. We hate it. If he calls, tell him.
Simple as that.
My first guest has been here many times before this appearance, but this is his first appearance as a bona fide movie star. His film Pee-wee's Big Adventure opens nationwide next Friday. Please welcome movie star Pee-wee Herman. Been a long time. You've been away making the film?
Yeah, I've been away making the film.
And congratulations. I understand it turned out very nicely. You're getting good reviews. You get some reviews, have you?
Yeah. I just happened to have a few of the reviews with me, Dave.
All right.
Look, Dave, I got something I really wanted to show you, babe.
What do you have there, Pee-wee?
It's this machine, Dave. Since, you know, you're in stereo now and everything.
Well, that's very thoughtful.
You can change your voice into a robot voice.
Uh-huh. Does that come off up often where you need to do that?
Yeah!
All right, let's see some of the reviews.
Okay, yeah, look. This is the Hollywood Reporter. That's a big, you know, trade industry paper. It says, this is the first sentence of the review. Pee-wee's Big Adventure isn't just the funniest movie of the year, it's one of the funniest movies ever! That's the Hollywood Reporter. Uh-huh. And then this one right here. Look at this big, that's the big advertisement right here about it.
This indicates how much business you've done the first week or something?
Yeah, but that's only in
a couple of theaters,
you know, not too many. But look, 4-star rating.
Highest rating. What does that say? Let me see that.
Yeah.
Highest rating. A delight. I like this movie so well that I've seen it twice. So on and so forth. Boy, that's very impressive.
Yeah, that's my dad's review.
Yeah.
And then look at this too. Look, Life Magazine.
Life Magazine?
Yeah, look, I'm in Life Magazine.
Oh, brother.
Yeah.
That's pretty impressive.
Big photo spread in Life Magazine.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And look at all this stuff too. Look. Look, here's Time. Vanity Fair. GQ. Muppet Magazine, Muscle and Fitness, Us Magazine, People Magazine, Super Teen Magazine, U.S. News, Forbes, Rolling Stone, Star, Der Spiegel, The Figaro, Stern, West Africa Magazine, Paris Match, Playgirl.
Now, here in the August issue of Vanity Fair, I don't see any movie review at all. No, not only your movie, it doesn't appear to be any movie in this one.
Oh!
tell me about the movie.
Well, it's a really, really cool movie, Dave. I'm glad you asked about it.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Pee-wee's Big Adventure, which you already said, and it's based on a true story, a true life adventure that happened to me. And it's basically the story of what happens when my most prized possession in the whole world, my bicycle, which is a real, not just a regular bicycle, it's a souped-up, special, super-duper, you know, special bike that's, besides my transportation, it's my hobby and, you know, all that stuff, and it gets ripped off.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So
that's the whole movie.
It's kind of what I call a quest film. Mm-hmm. You know, it's all about what happens to me in order to get...
for 90 minutes? 90 minutes?
Well, you just read the reviews, didn't you? it holds up pretty good.
Now, you know, it's interesting, Pee-wee. Have you thought about this now that the film's a success? That means that for the rest of your life, you'll have to dress like that.
Yeah. Yeah, no sweat off my back, though,
okay.
Really.
We have to do a station identification. And then we'll be right back. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Okay, one of the most powerful men in show business, ladies and gentlemen, Pee-wee
I know
Herman.
You are, but what am I?
Yeah. We'll be right back, folks. Welcome back to the the show, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow. Paula Poundstone will be here, and Marv Albert and singer Nina Hagen. You know Nina Hagen?
Yeah, we're like this.
This is Pee-wee Herman here. Let me read you a little thing here out of the New York papers about the premiere of your film. When is it going to be?
It's going to be this Thursday,
Thursday
at the
night.
Cool Chinese Theater in Hollywood.
Right there on the Hollywood Boulevard.
Yeah, they wouldn't let me put my hands and feet in cement, so I'm bringing a portable cement thing so I can do it, and then if they ever want to do it, then they'll already have it. Yeah.
Okay. Among those expected for Pee-wee's big night are Prince. Yeah, he won't be anywhere near the place.
No, he assured me personally.
No, he didn't. You don't know this guy.
Yes, I do. I know him really good.
He doesn't go anywhere.
No, he hangs out with me all the time.
You don't know him.
Yeah. I just went to his birthday party a couple weeks ago, about a month ago.
No, you didn't.
Did so!
All right, so we know Prince won't be there.
Yeah.
Eddie Murphy?
Eddie Baby?
I have a feeling he'll be with Prince that night. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, no, we have some, we have a scene. We're gonna show a clip.
Oh, really? A clip?
Yeah. do you wake up in the morning and say to yourself the first thing, did I take my medicine? Okay.
So funny, I forgot to laugh.
Okay, here. Pee-wee, tell him what the clip is.
Well, as I said, it's a quest film, and I go through all these different kind of situations to try to find the bike.
Right.
And this is one of them where I go into a biker bar.
A biker bar. Pee-wee Herman in a biker bar. Okay, here we go. Color?
Color!
Pee-wee's big adventure. Pee-wee, congratulations. I'm very happy for your success. Good luck with the film. We'll be back after this. Come back again, Pee-wee.